24, 2011, City Council's regular meeting to order and request a roll call, please.
Tom McCune.
Here.
Lori Sane.
Present.
Joe Baker.
Here.
Jay Cole.
Here.
Kevin Plank.
Here.
Steve Bruno.
Here.
Charles Sigmund.
Present. We have quorum status. Ask those in the audience to join us in the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Thank you. We are now to our public comment on issues not scheduled on the agenda. Do we have any public comment?
Name is Richard Kimball, 1209 McLaughlin Court, Dacono. I brought this issue up once before and evidently, there's no violation if a person turns in the middle of the street. Well, now I want to bring it up again because safety issue. Down here at our Green Meds place, it's getting a little wild down there. When you're coming down the street, people are headed south and all of a sudden, they whip right around in front of you, cutting you balls, get over there to park. There's been about three times that I've about been in an accident there. I don't know if anybody else has said anything about it, but just this last week, I was coming down Glendale Circle, and it's not just right in front, it's going up to the intersection and whipping a U-ey right in the intersection because it happened, and I run into the mayor down there at the post office mailing something off, and I asked him, I said, you see what that idiot just did? Well, he hadn't seen it, he was down there and everything. But they whip up and they turn right in the middle of the intersection and cut a U-ey right in the middle of there, and it doesn't matter. You know, if anybody's coming, I've seen people slam on brakes and everything before. And I was just wondering if the council could look at this and put up a no U-turn sign there or something. If I remember right, there is parking area on the north side of them buildings where people can go in there, park, and get out and walk up to that place. But I don't think they need to be cutting U-balls. I mean, in a hurry like that right in front of you. They don't even look. Don't turn signal on or nothing. Just cut a U-ball. Or maybe get the city police out there to watch them a little bit. But I guess if there's no ordinance against it, you can't do nothing against it. So I just want the city council to consider something like that before there's an accident there. Thank you.
Okay, is there any other public comment? Okay, seeing none. We are now to the consent agenda, which consists of the minutes of the January 10th, 2011 regular meeting, accounts payable dated January 24, 2011 in the amount of $52,002.21, and for approval of resolution 11-04, appointing directors to fill vacancies on the board of directors of the Pinnacle Farms Metro District. Council, do you wish to have any of these items removed? If so, which ones? If not, I would entertain a motion.
I move to approve the consent agenda as provided.
Second.
Okay, motion made by Cole, seconded by McCune. Can I receive a vote, please?
Tom McCune?
Yes.
Lori Sane?
Yes.
Joe Baker?
Yes.
Kay Cole?
Yes.
Kevin Plank?
Yes.
Steve Bruno?
Yes.
That motion carries with all voting yes. We are now to our general business, which consists of a public hearing of Ordinance 750 granting a non-exclusive cable television franchise to Comcast Colorado LLC, amending corresponding provisions to the Dacono Municipal Code and approving a letter of agreement with Comcast on second reading. At this time, I open the public hearing.
Good evening, Council. This is a second reading on an ordinance we heard at the last meeting for a non-exclusive cable television franchise. And I'll go over some of the highlights that I went over last time. It's a five-year agreement, and it provides us with a dedicated, shared educational and government channel. They call it the PEG channel. It, which is 16, has requirements for expectations when work is done in the city's rights of way. It has a requirement that new or upgraded facilities are installed underground, minimum programming categories and number of channels, a franchise fee equal to 5% of the annual gross revenues received by Dacono subscribers, a cable system performance standards, and the provision of free basic cable service to public, private schools, and government buildings. And it also gives us the ability to implement a PEG contribution fee of 50 cents per month per residential customer to maintain and operate our local PEG channel. Just to clarify that, like I mentioned last time, approving this ordinance doesn't implement the fee. That is a separate action that's done down the road when that comes into play. In addition to the new agreement, the ordinance also revises our municipal code to reflect the appropriate changes, and also approves a side letter agreement with Comcast that specifically addresses how the PEG channel will transition. Currently, we bring our tape over to the Frederick office, or DVD rather. It's played for a period of time, and then it's a manual process taken on. It's a manual process. The letter agreement provides equipment that Comcast will provide, and it will be installed, looks like right now, at the Longmont office. Last week it was going to be the Frederick office, and then it changed again to be the Longmont facility. So that's the latest installation news I have on it. And their plan is to close the Frederick office within 60 days of execution of the letter by all three communities and after the equipment has been installed at their facility. Absolutely no changes have been made to the ordinance or side letter since the first reading. And I will entertain any questions if there are any.
They have an office still in Fort Upton, right?
That I don't know. I can check into that.
Thank you. Is there anybody from Comcast that wishes to speak on this matter? Okay. Anybody from the public wishes to speak?
I just have a question. I'm sorry, I wasn't here for the first reading. The 50 cents, is that if you're just a member, if you subscribe to Comcast, or is that going to be overall charged to anybody?
Only if you are a subscriber.
Oh, okay. Thank you.
Is there anyone else from the public that wishes to speak? Okay. Seeing none. So at this time, I close the public hearing and turn it back over to council for discussion and any motion.
I'll make the motion if there's no discussion. Approving ordinance 750, granting a non-exclusive cable television franchise to Comcast of Colorado 4 LLC, amending corresponding provisions of Dacono Municipal Code, and approving a letter agreement with Comcast on second reading.
I'll second.
Motion made by Baker, seconded by Cole. May I receive the vote, please?
Lori Singh.
Yes.
Joe Baker.
Yes.
Nick Cole.
Yes.
Kevin Plank.
Yes.
Steve Bruno.
Yes.
Tom McCune.
Yes.
That motion carries with all voting yes. Next item. Consideration of Resolution 11-05, finding substantial compliance for Como LLC annexation. And Jennifer is going to be our presenter on this.
Good evening, Mayor and Council. For your consideration is Resolution 11-05. Finding substantial compliance for an annexation filed with the City of Dacono for the Como LLC annexation. In your packet, let me just walk through that first. You have a copy of the resolution, a copy of the legal description, the actual petition that was submitted, a annexation map showing the area to be annexed, and then the last page is my handiwork, which is just a map that I put together just to kind of put it in perspective as to the annexation area that we're talking about. And I'll start with that. The annexation area contains just a little bit over 76 acres, and it's located along the Eastern I-25 Frontage Road, just south or adjacent to the Erie Salvage Yard. So the map, the area to be annexed is enclosed in that red triangle. And so at the top of your map is Silver Peaks, then the Erie Salvage Yard, and then the annexation area. So the purpose of a resolution finding substantial compliance is that, as a city council, you find that the annexation proposal, or petition rather, meets the statutory requirements, that there is not an election required, that this is a voluntary annexation. As staff, our city engineer has verified the legal description and found that it meets all applicable standards regarding contiguity. And then you're also going to be setting a public hearing date. And tonight, the intent really is not to discuss whether or not the city wants to annex this land, but rather just to approve, or consider rather, the resolution of substantial compliance. The public hearing date is set for, March 14th. And at that night, you'll hold a hearing on the annexation, consider an annexation resolution, an annexation agreement, as well as zoning. Staff is recommending approval of Resolution 11-5, finding substantial compliance for annexation. Are there any questions?
Do we know what Como LLC does?
They're actually, I believe, a holding company.
It's a management company.
Right.
Thank you.
Who are the owners?
On the annexation petition, it does. Robert Fleming is the person I've been working with on behalf of the company, and I believe George. Gosh, the name escapes me.
Find out before March 14th.
Well,
the property is actually owned by Como LLC.
Oh, okay, a group of people.
It's a limited liability.
Any other questions for the expert this time?
So what's in it for them, I guess?
Well, let's look at what's in it for the city. Well, this area is within the city's planning boundary. And long-term, through the city's comprehensive plan, city has determined that should this land become urbanized or developed, it should be done within the city of Dacono. Several months ago, Bill and I actually met with representatives from Como LLC and said, if you want to develop, we really strongly recommend that you annex into the city of Dacono, because for a development that they are proposing, although we don't have any plans that have been submitted, it needs to be within the city limits of Dacono. And they also agreed, also because they want city services, city water. So it's obviously mutually, it benefits one another.
What do you wish to do with this?
Motion to approve Resolution 11-05, finding substantial compliance for Como LLC annexation.
Second.
Motion made by Baker, seconded by Sain. Can I receive a vote, please?
Joe Baker?
Yes.
Kay Cole?
Yes.
Kevin Plain?
Yes.
Dean Bruno?
Yes.
Tom McCune?
Yes.
Lori Sain?
Yes.
That motion carries with all voting yes. We have another public hearing for approval of Resolution 11-06, approving a special use permit for Kern McGee Oil and Onshore LP and Anadarko Company to locate oil and gas wells within the city of Dacono, Pinnacle Wells. So at this time, I open this public hearing.
Mayor and Council, this is consideration of Resolution 11-06 approving a special use permit for the Pinnacle Wells. You have in your packet tonight a staff report, portions of the special use permit application, and a photo of the location of